like most other viruses, this new coronavirus attached to the cell surface first. This coronavirus uses a protein called ACE2. So when virus attaches to this receptor, receptor is engulfed by the cell, internalized by the cell. And that is a part of a natural function of the receptor to bring in the ligand of the receptor. That's how the virus gets into the cell. There are two reasons why a virus make people sick. In the case of this new coronavirus, a virus infected our cells and they replicate and amplify that damages and kills the cells. And another reason that might be more important is when we are infected with a pathogen, our immunity reacts to it and send the immune cells to the infection site. In the case of a new coronavirus, the infection site is lung, the lower lung. So the inflammation caused by accumulation of these immune cells in the lung is called pneumonia. And the job of these immune cells is to get rid of these invading pathogens, and they do so by killing these infected cells. So as a side effect of this killing cells, we feel sick. This coronavirus is transmitted majorly through aerosol contact. So aerosol is created by sneezing, coughing, or talking by an infected person. So that is the major route. When aerosols land on our mucosal membrane in the eyes, nose, and mouth, and that's how we get infected. Some people say that, oh, why do we worry about this virus so much? Because it does not kill so many people, so probably we should just get infected and get over with it and, you know, develop immunity. But I don't think so. So it infects lower part of the lung where structure is extremely delicate. So when those cells are damaged or removed by viruses themselves or by our immune system, we just do not know what could be the long-term effect of it. So even if we are not killed but survive coronavirus, maybe 10, 20 years later, we have a breathing problem or it very easily develop pneumonia. So we just don't know.